Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be painting the ancient Egyptian god Osiris, and I will give you some information about him. Osiris is the god of fertility, agriculture, the afterlife, the dead, resurrection, life, and vegetation in ancient Egyptian religion. He was classically depicted as a green-skinned deity with a pharaoh's beard, partially mummy-wrapped at the legs, wearing a distinctive atef crown and holding a symbolic crook and flail. The crook and flail were symbols used in ancient Egyptian society. The crook is thought to represent Osiris as a shepherd god. The symbolism of the flail is more uncertain, with shepherd's whip, flying whisk, or association with the god of Enjedi of the ninth nome of the Lower Egypt proposed. Also, they are known as the shepherd's crook stood for kingship and the flail for the fertility of the land. He was commonly depicted as a pharaoh with a complexion of either green, the color of rebirth, or black, alluding to the fertility of the Nile floodplain in mummy form. Osiris is the mythologically father of the god Horus. The myth describes Osiris as having been killed by his brother Set, who wanted Osiris' throne. His wife Isis finds the body of the Osiris and hides it in the reeds, where it is found and dismembered by Set. Isis retrieves and joins the fragmented pieces of Osiris, then briefly revives him by use of magic. This spell gives her time to become pregnant by Osiris. Isis later gives birth to Horus. Since Horus was born after Osiris' resurrection, Horus became thought as a representation of new beginnings and the vanquisher of the usurper Set. Annual ceremonies were performed in honor of Osiris in various places across Egypt. These ceremonies were fertility rites which symbolized the resurrection of Osiris. Recent scholars emphasize the androgynous character of the Osiris fertility, clear from surviving material. For instance, Osiris' fertility has to come both from being castrated, cut into pieces, and reassembled by female Isis, whose embrace of her reassembled Osiris produces the perfect king Horus. Further, as attested by tomb inscriptions, both women and men could syncretize with Osiris at their deaths, another set of evidence that underline Osiris' androgynous nature. You can find the watercolor palette and the paper in the description box. Also, acrylic painting set and water resistance pen are in the description. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want, you can follow me on Instagram for more artworks. See you soon. Bye.